Many people are bored of studying English in the traditional methods. If you are or aren't, come and visit our teaching oasis. We are teaching English via science. You are going to read, watch, and listen to very interesting scientific topics. In the description of each video, you will find links to explanations, quizzes, and many interesting exercises that cover the language used in the video you watched. The most interesting thing is that you can reach the same topic in more than one accent. On Teaching Oasis channel, learning never comes to an end. Don't wait, let's start. There are a lot of snake species in our world. The small, the big, the venomous, or nonvenomous. Snakes that live in the desert, the forest, or in the water. Snakes that crawl, swim, or even fly. Snakes that eat animals, birds, fish, or that eat each other. Despite studying all these types of snakes, many are still asking this question: is the two-headed snake real? That is what we are going to study today. But don't forget to subscribe to our channel, Teaching Oasis, to receive every new video. It is said that two heads are better than one. But I think it doesn't work in the case of this two-headed cobra that was discovered in China in August 2015. Mr. Hung found the baby Chinese cobra on his farm in Yulin, southern China. This rare two-headed albino Honduran milk snake was hatched in Florida. The owner was the biologist Daniel Parker. The snake was not only colorful, but also the two heads were perfectly formed. The strange thing is that he put the rare milk snake up for sale at a whopping $25,000. This rare two-headed rattlesnake, named Double Dave, has been found in a forest in New Jersey, the United States, 2018. The name Double Dave was coined because it was discovered by the environmentalist Dave Schneider and his colleague Dave Burkett. They were observing rattlesnakes giving birth. They were not expecting to find one with two heads. This rare two-headed cobra was spotted in India's eastern Mindapore city. The snake caused a stir as it became the center of attention. Villagers fed it milk and refused to hand it over to forest officials, as they said they associated it with mythology. In Tennessee, 2011, Paul Carver found this baby king snake slithering around his Montgomery County backyard. He realized the royal serpent would need two crowns. This two-headed western rat snake was found in Stone County, Missouri, in 2018. A teenager named Terry Lowry found the snake under the deck of his family's home in Hurley, in Stone County. The Lowry family requested, if possible, that the snake be displayed to the public. A woman discovered this rat snake when her dog started chasing something under her front porch. The West and Taylor family took the reptile to Waco's Cameron Park Zoo. Two-headed snakes rarely survive in the wild. A rare wolf snake with two heads has been discovered in the Dehenkakot forest range of Kianjar Wildlife Sanctuary in Odessa. It was found by photographer and wildlife enthusiast Rakesh Mahalik. The snake is nonvenomous and measured 14 centimeters in length. Surprisingly, some people think that two-headed snakes, such as red sand boa, will bring its owner treasure. So demand for the snake is high, with people even hiring them out for ceremonies. It is even believed that the heavier the snake, the more riches it will bring. Having two heads is called Dice Valley. A mysterious disorder occurring in just one out of every 10,000 snakes born in the wild, and one out of 10,000 born in captivity. Scientists suspect it happens when a developing embryo begins to split into identical twins, but then stops partway. Although most polycephalic snakes have a short lifespan of only a few months, one two-headed king snake reportedly lived for 17 years in Arizona University. It is hard to adapt in the wild. It would be much harder to catch prey, and it could be caught easy too. Snakes operate a good deal by smell, and if one head catches the scent of prey on the other's head, it will attack and try to swallow the second head. We wish that you learned something new. If you like the video, don't forget to subscribe and click like. We'll be appreciated if you share it too. This is The Teaching Oasis.